We didn't know if it could happen, but it's finally here, the Tokyo 2020 Olympic Games, and I can't tell you how excited I am that they are on. I think I've overdosed on the Olympics already, and so I thought I'd take you through a little bit of a journey day by day of what's happened so far. So first up was the opening Olympic ceremony, and it was so nice to see Japan and Tokyo pull it all together and put on a show, as well as bring all the athletes and countries together for the Parade of Nations, where the flag bearers hold their flags up high. A little bit of a somber feeling with no crowd in the stadium, but everyone, the athletes and the team who've overcome so many challenges to even get there, waving to all their country people back home to the camera. There were 205 nations that got involved, and it was in a different order. It was in the Japanese alphabetical order, hence why Iceland came before Azerbaijan. Really cool highlights, the Portuguese team bringing all the vibe, whirring their flag around and around, and the Tongan flag bearer as well, who made many a news article. Looking pretty fit for his upcoming taekwondo matches. And so other highlights were the drones that went above the stadium. Over 1,000 of them created these 3D images, including the world. Check out the video. And performers hit 50 pictograms of the events of the Olympics. I was so stressed watching it with the cameraman going this and that way and all the logistics, hitting it on the beat. Check that out as well. And you couldn't forget the lighting of the cauldron by Naomi Osaka. It was a gorgeous moment for Japan, and she was looking the part, loved her hair. Okay, so day one of the Olympics, there was a lot happening. I was glued to the TV for the smorgasbord that was all the sports. You had boxing, you had dressage, soccer, you had beach volleyball, you had hockey, you had water polo, you had judo. There's so much going on. Let's check out some of the sports. Day two, we're back, and our nation's favorite sport to watch is on the swimming. We won our first gold medal thanks to our girls in the 4x100 meter relay with a world record. And sadly, we did have a couple of shocks with Ash Barty out of the tennis and also Steph Gilmore out of surfing. But in an awesome win for Austria, Anna Kaisenhofer from the cycling road race had an awesome win. She led from the pack at the start of their 137 kilometer race, which has never had a win from that breakaway that early. Very well done. And the skating was also on for the guys. 45 seconds a run to do 5 tricks. First time it's been in the Olympics. They've got their AirPods in. They're the coolest people going around at the Olympic Village, I'm sure. And for that 45 seconds, I'm gonna ask you, what song would you have to pump you up to win an Olympics? Day three, what a big day. I kicked it all off by watching some of them gymnastics and saw Simone Biles doing her thing for the first time. She was on the floor and she was so impressive, so powerful with her leaps, bounds, somersaults, twists. She even came off the mat and into the blue section at one time, and they said, don't even worry about that. With those mistakes and even those deductions, she's still gonna be on top of the leaderboard. What a legend. And then we had the swimming. Incredible. The race we were all waiting for, the women's 400 meter freestyle, our very own Ariane Titmus was taking on USA's Katie Ledecky, the queen of the pool, and could she do it? 400 meters is a long way to be swimming flat out. You've got your own race plan, and she came through with the goods. With about 10 meters to go, she overtook Katie, hit the wall, and won gold for Australia with an Olympic record. And it gets better with her coach's celebration. Dean Boxall goes ballistic up in the stands. Check out the video. From the high to the low news, this morning at the men's triathlon, there was a bit of a bungle at the start where a boat was in the middle of the course at the starting point. The gun has gone off and 2/3 of the athletes have jumped into the water for it only to be called a false start, and they had to come back and re-go again. But in that commotion, a bit of a pity for our Aussie athlete, Jake Birthwistle, who had his nose broken in the commotion. He's still and came 16th, but who knows what it could have been, right? It's back to the skateboarding, debuting at the Games. It was taken out by 2 13-year-olds and a 16-year-old. Japan gold, Brazil silver, and then Japan again for the bronze. Go girls, so very cool. And lastly, we have the story of the diving, the men's 10-meter synchronized platform, with the Brits taking it out with Tom Daly and Maddie Lee. It's the story of Tom Daly in Olympics, where he's gone bronze, bronze, and now finally a gold. And his press conference was so uplifting that he is a gay man and also an Olympic champion, inspiring all the LGBTI community that they can achieve and that there is support out there. Go, Tom. Day 4 of the Olympics and another amazing scene at the pool with Aussie Kaylee McEwen winning the 100 meter backstroke. She's gotten gold, she made a world record in trials to get there, an Olympic record now, and it was just so beautiful. Her father passed away last year of brain cancer. She has a tattoo on her foot saying, "I will always be with you." Her mum and sister watched from Queensland and it was just so inspiring. Her coach Chris Mooney, so proud. And straight after the race, when emotions were running high, she was asked by an Aussie reporter if she had a message for her mum and sister watching back home. She leant into the microphone and said, "F yeah! Oh, did I just say that? I mean, yeah!" What a bloody Aussie legend. Everyone giving her so much support. In other Aussie news, Owen Wright took out bronze in the surfing debut for the men's, and also Jess Fox took out the bronze as well for the canoe slalom, and it's so nice, a family affair there with her mum as her coach and her dad commentating. The Australian Opals, our women's Aussie basketball team, also had their first game up against Belgium. They unfortunately lost by 15 points, but there's more games, so stay tuned there. And in awesome women's table tennis news, our very own Jiang Fang Lei is into the third round, and she is a legend in her own right. Her 6th Olympic Games as a 48-year-old. Can't wait to see what she does. And finally, the women's mountain bike riding. What an awesome course. And the Swiss took it out gold, silver, and bronze. And no wonder they did. Mountains are their backyard. But amazing to see all three of them up on the podium. It's day five of the Olympics, and the overnight news is that Simone Biles, the best gymnast of all time, I'm going to claim, has pulled out of the team event for America after an iffy landing after the vault. She cited that her mental health is going to take priority, and she didn't want to jeopardize the medal contentions for her teammates, which the USA team then did claim silver in that team event. And then Australia almost had just over an hour of power, winning six medals. I don't even have that many fingers to put up. Six medals, starting off in the pool with Ariane Titmus, again, our queen of the pool, winning gold in the 200 meter freestyle. So very exciting. Then the men took out bronze in the 4x200 meter freestyle. And then jump over to another water sport, but this time it's the rowing. Our women's four and our men's four got gold, and our quad scales both got bronze. So congratulations, a huge win for our rowing team. And lastly, we have the women's hockey roos in the match against Japan. In the last final minutes of the game, Maddie Fitzpatrick scored a goal for Australia, and it was awesome. There was a fake in there, it went straight in, and the girls celebrated, making 3 out of 3 wins and getting into the quarterfinal. Can't wait to see what happens next.